Now, Ujami, who's your free food and agriculture minister? Says so now, or the person will be the president. Minister. Who's your free? Anna, who pay you for no back, Papa? Only your pair president, didn't Minister of Trade and Industry, your bedroom, Papa. Wouldn't you know?
I think that about the Allen bit, I think over the years, Allen has built a very consolidated, you know, support base. Obviously, he's been running. So I'm not sure really that Baumia has or the other candidate have the ability to actually dissipate his vote. You know, if anything at all,
you think Allen has an unblocked vote?
No, he has a consolidated in a position. Over the years, he's been contesting. So his core base, you can be assured that he would be able to kind of put his core base together. Mm-hmm. Perhaps what is likely to be the issue are those previous, you know, candidates who have actually run before. For example, can he bring on board President Kufuor's, you know, support base, for example? Can he bring on board President Akufo-Addo's support base, for example? So those other support bases, that is the challenge, whether he can actually bring them as a coalition into his camp. But for his particular camp, I think he has a very consolidated position.
Even the president has made the point that he doesn't support any candidates.
Of course.
If you look at the president's posture now, which is 2021, or 2 years before the contest, and you look back at 2005, President Kufuor's posturing, do you get the sense that President Akufo-Addo would be believed if he says, given the way his role, his leadership and all that, whether he's believed if he says he doesn't support any candidate?
For me, I think that we have to give the president the benefit of the doubt. You know, obviously we can actually analyze it from the position of signaling, you know, some of his postures, etc., whether we can make meaning of it. But on the face value, we have to give him the benefit of the doubt to say that he's not actually supporting, but rightly so. Because when you are the leader of the party at the moment, the least you want to do is to split the party apart. Mm-hmm. So you want to actually stay in the middle. And just like President Kufuor did, you know, that I'm not supporting any candidate, although people thought that he was behind, you know, Alan Chamante, for example. That's the posture you would expect every president to take. But whether his other, you know, gestures, for example, and of course the doing of the vice president himself, you know, really buy into that particular position that he doesn't support, that's another conversation. But I think we can actually give the president the benefit of the doubt.
So you see who has been in the lead. Who is in the lead on your card?
For me,
it's early though, I have to admit.
Yeah, for me, I think that earlier on, we've seen Baumia. Obviously, we've seen kind of activity that he's been engaged in. Funerals, trying to put on, you know, Akan kind of dresses. In church, for example. So that actually tells you a candidate who's actually put themselves forward. Now, obviously, the last few days, we've seen some kind of Allen, you know, support base, you know, emerging. And that actually puts the contest right on its head, because you now have two contesting candidates actually going neck and neck after each other. I mean, if I should actually reflect on the kind of party NPP is, don't forget, NPP is a very establishment party. Mm-hmm. It's a party that actually goes for tradition. They hardly upset the tradition. And Baumia candidate, I'm afraid it's a little bit of anti-establishment, if we can actually put it that way.
You mean anti-historical establishment?
Exactly. I mean,
because other analysts will see Baumia as the establishment candidate in the context of being close to the people in power right now, those who control the NPP right now.
Yeah, of course, but his candidature itself is against the tradition. Mm. And that is why I think that is...
Given that he's not the next in line.
Exactly, because if you look at the NPP...
How do people become the next in line?
I mean, it's about years of stewardship. I mean, you hear party people talk about stalwarts, party stalwarts. Mm. Party stalwart doesn't actually come easy. You have to actually grow in a party.
How did Akufo-Addo become the next in line to Kufuor?
Yeah, because over the years, he had been at the forefront. Obviously, Kumi Preko, so many other policy positions. We saw him in parliament, you know, arguing forcefully against the Rawlings regime, etc. So the years of contribution, you know, years of contributing to the party. Yes,
okay, so why is Jogate not the next in line? Why is Alan Chematin the next in line?
You know, there is unofficial kind of structure in the party politics, especially when it comes to internal party politics. You have the layers, for example, the NEC, you have what we call the Council of Elders. There is also what you look at as the leadership structure. And if I give it a typical example, the videos that you saw President Kufuor then, you saw Selby, you saw Apraku, you saw, it tells the leadership of a particular party. And those people who actually contest see themselves as the legitimate leaders. And so when one is gone, they expect one to follow. And that's how the establishment actually comes.
Let me ask you a final question. Given that we already know who the opponent candidate is, which is most likely President Mahama, have you done any research to indicate the winnability quotient for Alan and Bawumia? If you haven't, is there a Kesri appreciation of something?
I think what can give us a picture, I haven't actually done a research so far to sort of put them head to head, but I think what actually gives us a sense is about the behavior of the voters, you know, in the past. You realize that the Ghanaian voters always go for, so to speak, an elderly person, and not only in Ghana, across the continent. Almost every African leader that you see there, you see a certain level of, you know, age. And I think one of the reasons why President Mahama actually struggled a little bit was because of the age factor. People associated young person to a certain lifestyle, and as a result...
Recklessness?
Well, you can actually say that. So even though he probably hadn't been that, because he was young, he was actually suffering.
So you're
from
saying that MPP's tickle. Winnability is the older than Mahama, the more winnable the ticket is.
Of course, because if you look at the behavior of the political, you know,
but this is not from research. This is your case.
No, this is my understanding of how.
I'd like to thank you, Doc.